Good morning students, today I am going to explaining the binomial distribution. The last class we discussed the probability mass function for discrete random variable, probability density function for continuous random variable, their properties and their related problems all are completed. Now I am going to explaining the again one more discrete distribution, binomial distribution. Binomial distribution. Binomial distribution. Here also define one discrete random variable. Let capital X be a discrete random variable. This random variable having a binomial distribution if its probability function defined is given by p of x equal x is n c x p power x q power n minus x, where x varies from 0, 1, 2, so on n. Binomial distribution. A random variable, a discrete random variable capital X is said to have a binomial distribution if its distribution is given by p of x equal x is ncx p power x q power n minus x, x equal to 0, 1, 2, so on n. That means x values are countable, finite number, where n is called number of trials. N is called number of trials. P is called probability of success. P is called probability of success. Probability of success. Q is called probability of failure. Q is called probability of failure. Probability of failure. P minus A, P plus Q is equal to 1, or Q is 1 minus P, or P is 1 minus Q. And N minus X is number of failures. X is called number of success. X is number of success. N minus X, number of failures. Number of failures. So this is the definition of binomial distribution. Once again, a random variable capital X is said to have a binomial distribution if its distribution is given by P of capital X equal X, NCX, P power X, Q power N minus X. The range of X is 0 to N. Remember it. N is called number of trials. P is called probability of success. Q is called probability of failure. And P plus Q is equal to 1. X is number of success. N minus X is number of trials, number of failures. That means binomial distribution is applicable to any random experiment when the number of trials are below 20. Remember it, below 20, finite number. More than 20, when n is large and p is small, then binomial distribution is approximated by Poisson distribution. Later we will discuss in the coming classes. When n is large and p is small, then the binomial distribution is approximated by Poisson distribution. That means binomial distribution is applicable to the random experiment whenever the n is small. N is small, that is below 20, n is below 20 or below 15. Otherwise we can apply Poisson distribution. Poisson distribution is also discrete distribution. Then now I shall discuss the mean of the binomial distribution. Mean of the binomial distribution, BD, mean of binomial distribution. It is a discrete distribution. So its mean is mean mu equal to or E of X is equal to, mean mu is E of X is sigma X equal to 0 to N X P of X. Why you are using sigma? It is a discrete. Suppose continuous integral. That is the difference between discrete and continuous. That equal to sigma x equal to 0 to n x, what is p of x? N c x p power x q power n minus x. That is the value of p of x. X n c x p power x q power n minus x. Then first x is 0, it is 0. X is 1, it is 1 into n c 1 p power 1 q power n minus 1. X is 2 n c 2 p square q power n minus 2. X is 3 n c 3 p cube q power n minus 3, so on n n c n p power n q power 0. That equal to n c 1 means n p q power n minus 1 plus 2 into n c 2 means n into n minus 1 by 1 into 2 p square q power n minus 2 plus 3 n c 3 means n n minus 1 into n minus 2 by 1 into 2 into 3 p cube q power n minus 3 plus so on plus n n c n is 1, so p power n into q power 0. Divide the summation. When x is 0, it is 0. X is 1 n c 1 p power 1 q power n minus 1. And x is 2 n c 2 p square q power n minus 2. X is 3, like that. And x is n. Here what is the common value in all the terms? Np. Np into remaining value q power n minus 1 plus here 2 2 cancel, n minus 1 into q power n minus 2 into p square, not p square, into p, plus here 3 3 cancel, remaining value n minus 1 into n minus 2 by 1 into 2. 1 into 2 means 2 factorial. P cube becomes p square into q power n minus 3 plus and so on. Plus lastly, n is the common value, so p power n minus 1 into q power 0. So q power n minus 2 and ends with, starts with q power n minus 1, ends with q power 0. Next, this is p power 0, p power 1, p square, so on, p power n minus 1. So by binomial expansion, within the bracket value can be written as p plus q whole power n minus 1. But p plus q value 1. So this is equal to np into 1 whole power n minus 1, that is equal to np. So the mean of a binomial distribution is np. The mean of binomial distribution is np. Second one, second parameter, variance of the binomial distribution. Variance of the binomial distribution. We know that sigma square represents variance, that equal to E of x square minus mu square. E of x square minus mu square, call it as 1. Separately calculate E of x square, where E of x square is, E of x square is equal to sigma x equal to 0 to n x square into p of x. Since it is a discrete distribution, x square into p of x, and that is equal to sigma x equal to 0 to n. This x square can be written as x into x minus 1 plus x into p of x. X square is x into x minus 1 plus x. That is x square minus x plus x. Both are cancelled. That is x square p of x. And again it is x equal to 0 to n split into two parts, x into x minus 1 into p of x plus sigma x equal to 0 to n x p of x. X p of x, that is equal to sigma x equal to 0 to n x into x minus 1 into, what about p of x? Ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. And what about second term, that is mean of the distribution, that is np, that is called np. Then that is equal to, and divide the summation, first term 0 when x is 0, when x is 1 is also 0, when x is 2 it is 2 into 1 nc2 p square q power n minus 2. When x is 3, 3 minus 1, 2, nc3, p cube, q power n minus 3, so on, plus last term. When x is n minus 1, ncn, p power n, q power 0, plus np. Next, when x is 0, it is 0. When x is 1, it is 0. So, when x is 2, 2 into 2 minus 1, 2 into 1. When x is 3, 3 into 3 minus 1, that is 2. And 2 into 1, nc2 means n into n minus 1 by 1 into 2, p square q power n minus 2, plus 3 into 2 into nc3 means n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 by 1 into 2 into 3 remaining, p cube into q power n minus 3, plus and so on, plus n into n minus 1, ncn is 1, p power n into q power 0, plus np. Again it is, common value is n into n minus 1 into p square. So, first term q power n minus 2. Second term plus n minus 2 into p into q power n minus 3. So, on last term p power n minus 2 into q power 0 plus np. So, what is this value? Q power n minus 2 starting value, ending value q power 0. Here p power 0, p power 1, p square, so on, p power n minus 2. So, by binomial expansion it is n into n minus 1 into p square into p plus q whole power n minus 2 plus np. Then e of x square is equal to n into n minus 1 into p square, p plus q is 1, 1 power n minus 2 is 1, plus np. So this value is n square p square minus np square plus np. Again it is n square p square minus plus np into 1 minus p. Here np is the common, here 1, here minus p. That equal n square p square plus npq. 1 minus p is nothing but q. That is the value of only e of x square. So, substitute this value in 1. So, sigma square is n square p square plus npq. And what about mu square? Mu square means n square p square. Since mu is np, so that is equal to npq. So, sigma square equal to npq. Standard deviation sigma is root over npq. So, the mean of a binomial distribution is np. The variance of a distribution is npq. Standard deviation of the distribution is root over npq. Once again, binomial distribution is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. X varies from 0 to n. N is called number of trials. P is called probability of success. Q is probability of failure, and moreover P plus Q is 1, X is number of success, N minus X is number of failures. That is the definition of binomial distribution. And what are the conditions for the existence of binomial distribution? N is small, N is small, P is large. Then when N is small, when N is large and P is small, then apply Poisson distribution. So what are the conditions here? N is small and P is large. So what are the first parameter of the binomial distribution? Mean. Mean of the binomial distribution is sigma x p of x. X varies from 0 to n. What is p of x? Ncx p power x q power n minus x. Divide the summation. When x is 0, it is 0. So starts with 1. 1 nc1 p power 1 q power n minus 1. Next x plus 2, 2 nc2 p square q power n minus 2 plus 3, 3 nc3 p power 3 q power n minus 3, so on. Last n, n ncn p power n q power 0. Nc1 means n, nc2 means n into n minus 1 by 1 into 2, nc3 means n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 by 1 into 2 into 3. Then take the common value. In all the terms, common value is np. Np into q power n minus 1 plus p into q power n minus 2 plus p square into q power n minus 3, so on, p power n minus 1 into q power 0. So highest value of q power n minus 1, least power q power 0. And similarly, p also starts with p power 0, ends with p power n minus 1. So this value by binomial expansion p plus q whole power n minus 1, that is nothing but 1. So the mean of the distribution is np. Similarly, variance of the binomial distribution, sigma square is e of x square minus mu square, call it as 1. Separately calculate e of x square, that is sigma x square into p of x. For the sake of convenience, this x square can be written as x into x minus 1 plus x. X square minus x plus x. And so split into two parts. X into x minus 1 into p of x plus x p of x. X into x minus 1, p of x is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. And the second part is the mean of the distribution, that is np. Next, x into x minus 1 into ncx p power x q power n minus x. Then it is sigma x equal 0 to n x into x minus 1 into p of x plus x f p of x. And this term is the mean of the distribution x p of x. So its value is np. Its value is np. Then it is x into x minus 1 into, what about p of x here? By binomial distribution, it is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x plus np. And divide the summation. Here when x is 0, it is 0. When x is 1, again it is 0, 1 minus 1. When x is 2, so the summation starts from 2. 2 into 1, nc2, p square, q power n minus 2. Next x is 3. 3 into 2, nc3, p power 3, q power n minus 3 plus np. So on, and when x is n, n, n minus 1, ncn, p power n, q power 0, so on, plus np. Divide the summation, starts with 2, next 3, so on, ends with n, plus np. Then here, nc2 means n into n minus 1 by 1 into 2, into p square, q power n minus 2, plus 3 into 2, nc3, n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 by 1 into 2 into 3. Ncn is 1 into, so on, n into n minus 1 into p power n into q power 0 plus np. Here in all the terms, the common factor is n into n minus 1 into p square. The remaining value q power n minus 2. Next, n minus 2 into this n minus 2 into p into q power n minus 3, so on. In last term, n into n minus 1 p square is the common value. So it is p power n minus 2 into q power 0 plus np. The highest power of q, n minus 2. Similarly, the highest power of p, n minus 2. But starts with q power n minus 2, ends with q power 0. So in the similar way, p power 0 starting value, ending value p power n minus 2. So by binomial expansion, within the bracket value can be written as p plus q whole power n minus 2 plus np. And moreover, p plus q is 1 or q is equal to 1 minus p. So this is n into n minus 1 into p square plus np. Then it is n square p square minus np square plus np. Then it is n square p square plus np. Here in both the last and second, last and last but one terms, the common value is np, that is 1 minus p, 1 minus p value q. So the npq, n square p square plus npq. So substitute this value in 1. What is 1? Sigma square is E of x square minus mu square. In E of x square, we can substitute n square p square plus npq. So sigma square is n square p square plus npq. Mu square minus mu square. What about mu? Np. Np whole square, n square p square. Then n square p square, again n square p square minus n p cancel, that is sigma square equal to npq. Therefore, the variance of the distribution is npq. The standard deviation is nothing but the positive square root of the variance, that is root over npq. So, this is standard deviation of the binomial distribution. So, we have three parameters. One is mean of the binomial distribution, variance of the binomial distribution, standard deviation of the binomial distribution. Now the mode of the binomial distribution. Mode of the binomial distribution. In general, mode is nothing but the maximum value of the binomial distribution. So mode is the value of x for which the distribution is maximum. Distribution, what is the distribution? Binomial distribution, that is ncx p power x, mode is the value of x, mode is the value of x such that p of x is maximum, p of x is maximum. So the mode of a binomial distribution is, mode of binomial distribution is two cases. One is an integral part of n plus 1 into p if n plus 1 into p is not an integer, then its mode is integral part of n plus 1 into p. Both n plus 1 into p minus 1 and n plus 1 into p, if n plus 1 into p is an integer. For example, if n plus 1 into p, n, what is n? Number of tiles. What is p? Probability of success. If n plus 1 into p is 5, 5 is an integer, then the modes are 4 and 5. The modes are 4 and 5. 4 is n plus 1 into p minus 1. 5 is n plus 1 into p. Since n plus 1 into p is an integer, if n plus 1 into p is 4.25, is not an integer, some decimal part is there, then the mode is integral part of 4.25, that is 4. Integral part of 4 is the integral part, 25 is the decimal part. So here integral part is 4. So the mode is integral part of 4.25, that is 4. The mode of a binomial distribution is obviously n plus 1 into p, but here two cases are exist. If n plus 1 into p is an integer, then the modes are n plus 1 into p minus 1 and n plus 1 into p. In second case, the distribution is called bimodal. The distribution is called bimodal. Bimodal means two modes are exist. Bimodal. In first case, if n plus 1 into p is not an integer, then the mode is an integral part of n plus 1 into p. In this case, the distribution is called unimodal, only one mode, unimodal distribution. In second case, bimodal distribution, since two modes are exist. So here, the mode of a binomial distribution is n plus 1 into p. If n plus 1 into p is an integer, then modes are n plus 1 into p minus 1 and n plus 1 into p. In that case, the distribution is called bimodal, since two modes are exist. N plus 1 into p is not an integer, then the mode is integral part of n plus 1 into p. So, in this case, the distribution is called unimodal. What is n? Number of trials. What is p? Probability of success. Then coming to the examples on binomial distribution, in which the first problem is two dice are thrown 5 times. Find the probability that getting 7 as a sum at least once, second one, third one is p of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 5. So, what is the experiment here? 2 dice are thrown at a time. How many times? 5 times. So, n is 5. What is the success? Getting 7 as a sum. At least 1 time, 2 times, and probability between 1 and 5. So, here coming to the solution. Here, n is 5, number of trials are 5. We have to conduct the experiment 5 times. So, n is equal to 5. So, what is S here? 2 dice are thrown. The sample space S consists of 36 elements. Like 1, 1. You already discussed 1, 2, 1, 3. So on. 6, 6. 36 elements. That is 36 elements. 1 1 1 2 1 3 1 4 1 5 1 6. Similarly, along with the 2, 2 1 2 2 2 3 2 4 2 5 2 6, like that up to 6 6, 36 elements whenever 2 dice are thrown at a time. Here 1 1 the sum is 2, 1 2 sum is 3, 1 comma 3 sum is 4, 1 comma 6 sum is 7. Here what is the success? P is equal to probability of getting 7. P nothing but probability of getting sum 7. Here the P nothing but 1 comma 6. Favorable cases of getting 7 is 1 comma 6, 2 comma 5, 3 comma 4, 4 comma 3, 5 comma 2, 6 comma 1, total 6 cases, 6 by 36. So, its value is 1 by 6. Getting sum 7, the favorable cases are along with 1, 1 comma 6, along with 2, 2 comma 5, 3, 3 comma 4, 4, 4 comma 3, with 5, 5 comma 2, with 6, 6 comma 1. So its probable cases are 6 out of 36. So P is nothing but 1 by 6. And what about Q? In general, P plus Q equal to 1 in a binomial distribution. P is 1 minus P, that equal 1 minus 1 by 6. Its value is 5 by 6. So the most parameters of binomial distribution are 3, N, P, Q. Binomial distribution total depends on 3 parameters, N, P, Q. What is N here? 5. P, we calculated 1 by 6. That is nothing but the probability of getting some 7. Q, 1 minus P. That is equal to 5 by 6. In any problem, first write the value of N, then calculate the value of P, then calculate the value of Q. Then coming to the first problem, P of at least once, probability of getting some 7 at least once. At least once means it is denoted by P of x greater than or equal to 1. Greater than or equal to 1. Greater than or equal to 1 means starts with 1. 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on. Or other option, 1 minus, the better one is x less than 1. Opposite of greater than or equal to 1 is less than 1. Then subtract from 1. Since total probability always 1. So it is 1 minus P of x less than 1. 1 minus P of x less than 1. That equal to 1 minus P of x less than 1 means P of x equal to 0. P of x equal to 0. What about P of x equal to 0? By binomial distribution, we have P of x equal to x is ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. This is the binomial distribution. Here, fixed values are npq, x variation. So, what is n? 5, c, x, 1 by 2, whole power x, q also, p is not 1 by 2, p is 1 by 6, q is 5 by 6, whole power n, 5 minus 6. This is the binomial distribution. General formula, ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. In this, fixed values are n, p, q. N is 5, p is 1 by 6, q is 5 by 6. So, P of at least once means P of x greater than or equal to 1. At least once means 1 or more than 1. So, greater than or equal to 1. This greater than or equal to 1, P of x greater than or equal to 1 can be written as 1 minus P of x less than 1 by the axioms of probability. Total probability is 1. So, 1 minus greater than or equal to 1 opposite value less than 1. So, P of x less than 1. Less than 1 means only 0 case, no negative values. So, 1 P of x equal to 0. P of x equal to 0 means in this result, replace x by 0. That is 5C0 1 by 6 whole power 0 into 5 by 6 whole power 5 minus 0. So, its value is 1 minus 5 by 6 whole power 5. 5C0 is 1, 1 by 6 whole power 0 is 1 into 5 by 6 whole power 5. Then coming to the second one, 2 times P of exactly 2 times, exactly 2 times, nothing but it is denoted by mathematically P of x equal to 2. P of x equal to 2 means in this result replace x by 2, that equal 5c2 1 by 6 whole power 2 5 by 6 whole power 5 minus 2. 5c2 is 10 into 1 by 6 whole square into 5 by 6 whole cube. That is the value of probability of exactly 2 times. Then coming to the third one, P of 1 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 5. Nothing but P of 1 x equal to 1, x equal to 2, plus x equal to 3, 4 and 5. 3, 4 and 5. In between 1 and 5. What do you have about 1? That is equal to, in this result, replace x by 1, 5c1, 5c1, 1 by 6, whole power 1, into 5 by 6, whole power 5 minus 1, 4, plus, what's the problem? 5c2, into 1 by 6, whole square, 5 by 6 whole cube plus 3, 5c3, 1 by 6 whole cube into 5 by 6 whole square plus 5c4, 5c4, 1 by 6 whole power 4, 5 by 6 whole power 1 plus 5c5, 1 by 6 whole power 5 into 5 by 6 whole power 0. This is the probability between 1 and 5. Simplify. 5c1 is 5, 5c2 is 10, 5c3, 5 into 4 into 3 by 1 into 2 into 3, 5c4 is 5, 5c5 is 1. Simplify. We get the required value in between probability of 1 and 5. 1 and 5. 1 and 5 means x equal to 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 1. P of x equal 1 means in this result, replace every x by 1. Replace every x by 2, we get P of 2. Replace x by 3, we get P of 3. Similarly, 4 and 5, we get the required result. Here, what is the experiment? 2 dice are thrown. How many times? 5 times. So, n is 5. So, what is the sample space? 2 dice are thrown. The sample space is consists of 36 elements like 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5 and so on. 6, 6. 36 elements. Therefore, what is P? Probability of getting sum 7. Sum 7 means 1, 6, 2, 5, 5, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, 2, 6, 1. So, probability is 6 by 36. 1 by 6. Q is 1 minus P. And binomial distribution formula, ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. And here fixed values are np, q. N is 5, p is 1 by 6, q is 5 by 6. So, substitute all values. Then coming to the first one, at least once. So, p of at least once means p of x greater than or equal to 1. That is 1 minus p of x less than 1. Less than 1 means only 0 case. 0 case means replace every x by 0 in this result. P of exactly 2 times, that is P of x equal to 2. In this case, replace x by 2 and simplify it. We get the required result. Simple problems. Next one, 1 to 5. So P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3 plus P of 4 plus P of 5. P of 1 means replace x by 1. P of 2, x by 2, 3, here x by 3, x by 4, we get P of 4, x by 5, we get P of x equal to 5 and simplify. No need to simplify also, not necessary. Then we get the probability between 1 and 5. This is the best example of binomial distribution. Thank you.